Hello everyone, in this video I am going to discuss about TS diagram for the Carnot cycle, how we draw the temperature entropy plot for the Carnot cycle. So here, this particular diagram we are drawing with the help of different values of temperature and entropy. So here we have one graph and the vertical side is represented as temperature and the horizontal side is represented as the entropy. So let me write down here, this is our entropy and this is our temperature. And here we have one Carnot cycle. So let me draw a proper Carnot cycle. So in Carnot cycle, basically we consider four processes. So here we have four processes, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is completely different from the PV diagram. Here in PV diagram, we usually write down the process 1 here, then 2, then 3, then 4. But here the values of the characteristics are changed. So the notations are also changing its place. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, this is the temperature entropy plot. And here, this Carnot cycle is represented by four lines, which is representing four processes. So, here, this 1, 4 is representing the constant temperature process. So, here at this point, we will consider temperature T1. And at this point, we will consider for the process 2, temperature T2. And at this point, let me write down the temperature T3 and at this point, the temperature is T4. Now here in Carnot cycle, if we draw the TS diagram, so it consists four processes. So two reversible adiabatic process and two reversible isothermal process. So it consists basically the Carnot cycle consists four processes. So we have four processes. Now what are these processes? So let me draw the processes here. And these processes are represented by the rectangular plane. So here our process 1, 4 is representing the heat addition. So it is represented by Q1. Heat is added here. Then heat rejection will be in front of Q1. So it will be Q2. And we have to consider the work done over the system and work done by the system. So here we have four processes. Now you can see the process 4-1. Process 4-1. So this process 4-1 is representing the reversible isothermal process. This process is represented as reversible isothermal process, where heat is added into the system at constant temperature from external source. So here temperature will be constant at 4-1 where heat addition is possible. So T1 will be equivalent to T4 for this process 4-1. Now let's see the process 1-2. So 1-2 is represented as reversible adiabatic process. It is reversible adiabatic process. And here we are considering the expansion. So reversible adiabatic expansion, we can say in place of reversible adiabatic process. So it is a reversible adiabatic expansion process where expansion is happening into the system, which produce expansion work. And the amount of work we are considering as WE. So this is represented as reversible adiabatic expansion process where we are getting work from the system in the form of WE. And here this is reversible adiabatic process, which is called isentropic process. Now isentropic means what? Isentropic means the entropy will be constant throughout the process. So S1 will be equals to S2. Now let's see the third process, 2-2-3. So 2-2-3 is representing reversible isothermal process. So let me write down here, This is again reversible isothermal process. And since it is reversible isothermal, so here T2 will be equivalent to T3. Throughout, temperature will be constant. And in this process, where heat rejection occurs from the system to external sink at temperature T2. So heat rejection is happening here. Now in process 3-4, it is representing again reversible adiabatic process. This is representing reversible adiabatic process. So it is again the isentropic process. So it is represented as S3 equals to S4. And in this process, what we have to do, it is representing the reversible adiabatic compression of the system, where this particular process will consume WC work. So here work done on the system we are considering in the form of WC. So this area 1, 2, 3, 4, you can see the cycle 1, 2, 3, 4. This is representing the Carnot cycle. So this is representing this complete area 1, 2, 3, 4 rectangle to represent the net work output per cycle. What is representing? It is representing the area net work output. The area is representing net work output. And here 4-1 is representing the quantity of heat added to the system. This 4-1 is representing the quantity of heat added to the system. And 1-2-3-4, this complete area is representing the net work output. So if we want to define the efficiency of Carnot cycle, so it will be defined as eta. So it will be equals to what? Q1 minus Q2 divided by Q1. Now here this Q1, Q2 we have to define in terms of temperature and entropy. Why? Because our plot is temperature entropy plot. So we know dQ by T equals to delta S integral, or suppose we are considering cyclic integral. So we can write down this dQ equals to delta S into T. So this dQ we can define as, or delta Q we can define as the amount of heat. So suppose if we are defining Q1. So Q1 will be what? Q1 we are considering between 1 and 4. And entropy is different here. Entropy is not constant. So it will be equal to what? T1 is the temperature, and the change in entropy will be S1 minus S4. Now similarly, we want to define the Q2. So Q2 will be here 2, 2, 3. So it will be S2 minus S3. S2 minus S3. And the temperature will be T2. So here we can put these values here. So our equation will be what? Let me write down here only. So it will be T1 S1 minus S4 minus T2 S2 minus S3 divided by T1 S1 minus S4. So this will be our equation. Now if we simplify this term, so we know from here S1 equals to S2 and S3 equals to S4. So if we put these values here, so our thermal efficiency equation will be T1 S1 minus S4 minus T2 S1 minus S4 divided by T1 S1 minus S4. So it will be equals to T1 minus T2 by T1. So this will be our equation of efficiency. Now we want to define the net work output. So it will be equals to Q1 minus Q2. So again it will be T1 minus T2 S1 minus S4. So here we have the net work done for the Carnot cycle in terms of temperature and entropy. And this is the equation of thermal efficiency in terms of temperature and entropy. Thank you so much.